Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Let's Play Okami HD. I'm your host, Ultra Director Jester. Today, we're going to be doing the Wanted List, the last real big obstacle on our list. Last time we did that was back in Season 1 when we started them, and a few episodes ago when I accidentally triggered one of the fights. So, we're just going to do a lot of monster hunting today, essentially. And, yeah, that's going to be a lot of fun. So, first place we're heading is near here, Tama's house. The way catching these monsters work is that one of these demon scrolls has one of the monsters we need to catch in it, so we need to wait until nightfall, of course, to do it. Otherwise, it won't work. I don't know, we gotta do everything at night here. You'll see. So, don't see any other ones around here, so this must be the guy we're looking for. And sure enough, he's how the string cutter appears! All I gotta do is just beat the crap out of the enemies and, well, there you go. This is Shinshu Field. This is the first area, and we're practically, well, we are gods at this point. So it's not gonna take very long to wrap this up, I'm sure. And then, if you might remember, after we destroy one of the wanted monsters, we need to cross his name out. Oh yes. How's that for immersive? Alright. That about does it for that. There's one more demon scroll here, and whoops! Well, luckily, this won't take long either. You know, it actually is a good thing that we're beating up these monsters, because the more monsters you defeat, the better off you're gonna be for, the S rank at the end. So, yes, kill those monsters. Anyway! Next place we're going to is about right here, because there's one special scroll at one of the intersections here. Make sure it's nightfall. Okay. Yep. Went a little too early on that one. All right. Now I think it's either this one or that other one I saw over there. Well, not this one. Dang. Oh well. All that does is just add more enemies to our list and give us more money. Can't complain there. By the way, we need a lot of money. We are excruciatingly low on money, if I didn't make that clear enough. So I think this is the scroll we need. Yeah, that's what I thought. Biwamaru the Vandal appears! And I'm pretty sure that the monsters that appear are random, but where they appear are not. Biwamaru didn't take that long, did he? Alright. Another one bites the dust. Now we gotta... You gotta cross out his name now. Oh, this is gonna be a fun episode. This is all we gotta do. Mess that one up. Yeah, with the control stick, it's kinda hard to do. Maybe I'm just inept, maybe my thumbs are no good anymore, but, you know, whatever. Alright, next place isn't that far away because there was something we missed here. Now that it's night, we can see where all the chests we missed are. And hey, we got a wooden bear out of the deal. Nice. Alright, I think our next scroll is around here somewhere. He's kinda near the Nameless Man's hut. It's not this one. Get out of here. Come on. Get out. No way. Also worth mentioning that you can farm for Demon Fangs here too if you have Golden Fury or Brown Rage. Alright. I think it was, might have been this one up here then, along the path. Yeah, there we go. Onimaru the Incorrigible! That's the last guy we need. And worth mentioning, if you defeat the wanted monster first, all the other enemies get defeated too. And it sadly reduces our chance to get Demon Fangs, but I think we might be alright for now. Well. Anyway! It takes care of our entire list here. We just need to see if we can't put it like... What? Like, I crossed it out. There. Well. Okay. Well, alright. That takes care of the priest's monster notebook. Let's head back and give it to him. As a reminder, he's by the Moon Cave entrance. It's where we started. So, make our way in here. He's still waiting for us. You know, I'm glad he was so patient. He waited 3 years to have this list cleared up. So he gives us gold dust. It may not seem like much, but it's actually very important, especially now. Let's see, I think we have... Okay. So, we'll use the gold dust here. We'll use that to power up our most powerful reflector. And it's good that we use this now, because there's not a whole lot of gold dust in the game, and we have two of the most powerful weapons in the game powered up, so, you know, we're good to go. We are A-okay. Alright, next up, we are heading to Seon City for the second of four wanted quests. Alright, the place we're heading to in particular in Seon City is in the Commoner's Quarters to Yama's Restaurant, kind of in the northeastern corner of the city. You come here during the day, nothing happens, because, as we all know, everything has to happen at night. So, we'll go ahead and make it night. As we do. And now our friend should be around here. The guy we're looking for. There he is. Alright. This is Masu. As in... Masamune, it's a very legendary blade. I'm sure everybody probably knows that if they ever played any Japanese-style game before in their lives. But, he's got a special problem! He has a whole list of enemies, or monsters, that he has to kill, but he's too busy getting drunk at the bar to go and actually fight them. Don't let alcoholism ruin your life, kids. So, actually, I don't blame him, because he's got five wind ears to take care of, and those guys are fucking annoying. So I'm not gonna give him too much trouble. Let's go ahead and, take care of this list for him. This actually isn't too difficult. So the place we're gonna head to is just regular old Ryoshima Coast. And they're practically pretty much all in a row. The first one is right outside the city gate, kind of down, kind of alongside the beach. Most of them are alongside the beach. Oh wait, Thunder Ears, my bad. Those are wind noses. I always get these body parts mixed up. Because he has an exercising arrow in it, that means that he's the guy we need for the wanted list. So let's take him out. Yeah! Good place for us to, Veil of Mist works very well. Good place for us to get Demon Fang. This is all very, very good stuff we're doing here. This is all totally worth it. I hope. So, alright, there's one down. Only five to go! Alright, and, I think I forgot which one I was fighting. Is that... Okay, yeah, that's Dishonorable Tempest. Let's see if I can actually cross him out. There we go. So I gotta line it up. Again, I feel like it's the control stick. Being able to work with that isn't exactly perfect. The next one isn't that far either. I think he's right through these trees here, and this guy right here. Yep, there he is. This is... Shame Flasher! Oh god! I can only shudder to imagine why he's getting what's coming to him. So yeah, Veil of Mist, spam, Golden Fury. You know, defeat the enemies no problem, and because we're so far into the game, we have the most powerful weapon now powered up, none of these wanted lists are gonna take that long. Alright, it's 2,000 yen. This is also a great way to earn money, too. So, alright. Go ahead and get Shame Flasher. Well, if he flashes, he really doesn't have any shame, does he? Alright, next one is over by Ankoku Temple. And of course he gets what's coming to him because he's hanging by the graveyard. Get away from those foxes! What the hell is he doing? I've actually never seen these spirits before. It's kind of cool. But yeah, this guy is the guy we're looking for. Petulant Lightning! Again, I'm pretty sure they're all random, so I think if you were to do this yourself, you'd probably get different enemies at different locations, but whatever. Anyway, we'll take this time to get some Demon Fangs, as we normally do. Wait, when people say that they don't like Okami because of the combat, I can kind of understand why. Sometimes it's not that engaging. Alright, it's number three down, I think. Number three? Yeah, that's it. I'm losing count here. Keeping track of too many lists, all at once. The best part about these wanted lists, is if you come in there powerful enough, you'll be bound to get cherry tree ranks every single time, so that's even more money in your pocket. But yeah, that's Petulant Lightning! Okay, now, you gotta head over by the save point. Because only the most dastardly of bastards would ever attack somebody by the save point. Come on out, foul thunder! Looks like he's ballsy enough to just be by himself. That's cool with me. Let's knock it down with Veil of Mist, and I'm gonna try and see if I can poop on him, because I think, Brown Rage gives you an extra Demon Fang, so that's a total of three Demon Fangs you can get from each monster, not counting their floral finishes, which I can't be bothered to remember for each of these monsters. Sorry. But that's Foul Thunder in the bag. Alright! Even though Thunder is sound and not actually light, but you know, whatever. Alright, see if we can't cross this guy off now without any problems. There we go. I don't know how that worked. But the game registers is kind of iffy sometimes. Alright, now we're heading north towards the Devil Gate. Because who else but a dastardly monster would hang out by the Devil Gate, among his own kind even? Last guy on our list, Storm of Degradation! Even sounds like a kind of a leader type guy for these kinds of monsters. But whatever, do the usual Golden Fury, Brown Rage. I kind of almost want to get them confused sometimes and be careful to make sure I don't say Golden Rage and Brown Fury, even though we kind of understand what they were at the same time anyway. I'm just going to keep on rambling and keep on going on the stream of consciousness until this guy is defeated. All right. I got a lot of cash. So, alright. It's the last guy on our list. All I gotta do is just cross him off now. And... Okay. I'll just cross him out. Oh, come on. Did you register already? Oh, for fuck's sake! That was fine! Oh, come on! Is it because he's too long? Ah, jeez. That was my fault. Come on! There we go. Can't I just, like, you know, have it locked in a straight line, maybe? You know, whatever. Let's head back to Seon City. Back to Yama's restaurant. Show off our completed list to our drunken samurai friend. Sup, dude? Finish your list. And he's sleeping. Hey, wake up. Wake up, dude, I got your list. Hey, man. Hey, man, I got your list. Is it glitched? What happened? Oi, I got your don't go back to sleep, I got your goddamn list! Okay, so, turns out he sleeps at night, as most humans do. I wouldn't know. Turns out we gotta make it morning now, because it turns out not everything is done at night. Who would have fucking guessed? And there he is, walking around town. Because what's it matter? It's a day of darkness. It's all gonna be dark, you know, all the you know, whatever. Show him the completed list. At first he's pissed, and then he's kind of relieved. And he gives us some more gold dust. Huh. Well, yeah, okay then. Alright, on to our next location. And if you can't read that, that says Kusanagi Village. So, yeah. Our third of four wanted lists is actually at Kusanagi Village. Actually, just Kusa Village, because I think they shortened a lot of the Japanese names into much more easier pronounced ones for the Western release, but for some reason I kind of remember the PS2 version actually having those full pronunciations. Oh, heck. God, that's a long way up here. Jeez. Okay, so here we are in Kusa Village. The place we're heading to first is the inn. If you don't know what the inn is, it's this building right back here. Thankfully, not that far. We gotta make our way up to the second floor. Oh, but first, let's put a little eye on that Dharma guy. Whoop. Hey, look at that! He gives us an exorcism slip. It's a small one, but we can still sell that for some cash. That'll be nice. Alright, so, place you guys seek. Oh, yeah. Back here. Go ahead and knock once. I guess that was supposed to be comedic or something, but you know, okay. Well, see, this Haruka chick is where our next wanted list is, but she's not cooperating with us right now because she's changing, I suppose, so we just have to wait. Yeah. So, let's just give her a day. We'll just head outside, change it tonight, and then change it right back to day again. Again, it's a day of darkness. Why does it matter? It's all dark all the same. Anyway. After a day has passed, or whenever you decide to knock on the door when you first come here and then come back later, around this time, but anyway. You knock on the door, she's not there. Let's see then. Not over here, but extra yen. Extra food, that equals extra yen. And there she is, alright. Of course, it's the last place we look. I actually spent a good 5 minutes trying to find her. Yeah. Anyway. She's got a problem herself. And she remembers us as that very rude dog. You know, dogs don't tend to knock. Although I've never really taught one to knock, but, you know. So yeah. Third verse, same as the first. She's got some monsters that need to die. This ill-fated beauty. So she hands us a list that's got, oh, great, dead fish. Those are those suicide bombing enemies. Again, I can see why you wouldn't want to deal with those. Those are a little bit tricky to deal with. Yeah, I can. That's fine. So, we have Haruka's revenge contract. Let's go contract some revenge for her. All right. So the revenge contract takes place at Taka Pass, and we're going to start by heading to the very left side of the map, where we find this pile of leaves that has a chest that we haven't seen before yet. That has a holy bone in it. Not really a big, massive treasure, but still a nice treasure nonetheless. And I'm pretty sure that our first guy is around here somewhere. Maybe it's this guy? No, it is not this guy. But you know what? I'll take the enemies defeated and the money and any potential demon fangs all the same. Oh, he died. Ah, well. I'm hunting for monsters, really. I'm not really hunting for too many demon fangs right now. At least we're getting a lot of money out of it. Good chunk of it, at least. Alright, if he's not by the hard dig spot, he must be right by Bingo. Yeah. Like a truly dastardly son of a bitch, whatever, trying to attack someone as noble as Bingo is, I guess. And we find Red Devil the Detested. Yeah, that's a pretty detested Red Devil, alright. And fortunately, it doesn't take long at all to take him down. Especially with us being so overpowered at this point that we can take him out before he can have a chance to explode all over us. Ew. Anyway. That's our first of five. We have only 9 enemies left to go in this episode. Alright, let's see. Red Devil the Detested. Shit. Come on. Gotta get it right. It gets harder to do because my hands are getting tired from doing this. There we go. Alright. Alright, move on to the next one, which is just over here past the bridge. I mean, think about it. Of course a horrible monster would ever try and attack merchants and travelers going up over a bridge, like the trolls normally do, but yes, this is Weirdo the Abhorrent! Weirdo the Abhorrent. That was my nickname in college. Anyway, he doesn't go down without too much of a fight, like normal, and... be a little clingy when you're trying to do Golden Fury. And, it's a very interesting death scream he's got there. Look how it kind of lingers through the whole cutscene. Well, that's our next monster here. Alright, let's go ahead and crest out Weirdo the Abhorrent. Oh, come on. Can I just check it off or something? Do I really have to cross it out? Just come on. There we go. It's getting harder to do. My thumbs are getting tired. Alright. Next area is... Oh, not that way. This way over here. Go head towards head to the tunnel that leads to the Konohana Sakuya Blossom. And then turn left, we'll find, ooh, hey, look at that. I mean, it's daylight, yeah, but... Let's see. Yeah, there's some horses here we haven't fed yet. That means extra praise. Alright, I guess you guys don't eat meat. Alright. So have some herbs, and you can give me some praise. You can give me, eat praise. Not bad, not bad. Now, I don't think we can cut this yet. Oh, we can. Oh, never mind. Because we have power... That's right, we have Power Slash 2 now. So we'll bloom that clover, and that gives us an extra 40 praise! Beautiful! Yes. Now, there was a Demon Skull here last I checked. So we'll make it nightfall so we can see him again. And there he is. This is probably what the guy we're looking for. Yep, I knew it. Deathfin the Repugnant! I'd name my son Deathfin the Repugnant. And I bet you can guess how well this goes. I'm glad I'm doing this at the end, where it's not very exciting, and I do everything easily, and it only takes a few hits. There's no tension to be had. This is a great idea. Many people are going to be watching this. Anyway, self-deprecating humor aside, let's go ahead and cross out Deathfin the Repugnant, and yeah, first try. Ha-ha! Alright, next up, we're gonna be heading towards this open area down here. Now, if you've already purified the area, you'll see plenty of Demon Scrolls hanging around. One of them is bound to be what you're looking for. Because here we found Curse Gil the Repulsive. Are you sure it's not just regular Gil and we have to curse him? Like, curse you, Gil the Repulsive? Or is he actually really called Curse Gil? I don't know. Monsters have weird names. Too bad he won't live to tell about it anymore. Alright. That's one more down. One more to go. Well, 6. Yeah. This is a kind of okay way to get money, but not a very fast way of getting it. Alright, so we'll just cross out. There we go. Alright. One guy left. Again, if you've already purified the area, you search around long enough, you should find the guy who should be our dude. This is a mess. And I don't think I showed this off, but you can escape if you need to. That's handy. Alright, maybe we'll try this guy next. Hanging out by these cheetahs. Aha! You leave those animals alone! Bulging eyes, the despised. I don't know why you all have individual names if you all act and look the same. But yeah, a combination of Veil of Mist and I think Gale Storm should take him down, but at this point, just brute strength works just fine on itself. I'm trying to get some demon fangs out of him, but I think I missed my chance. Oh well. No big deal. There's still plenty of time to farm for demon fangs and money and enemies. And I believe that is the end of the list for Haruka. Rare revenge has been contracted. If I can just fucking cross out this name. Why is it so hard to cross out names? It's just a straight line. Come on. I don't think that people will be that picky in real life. Ah, whatever. Alright, now we'll head back to Kusa Village and get our reward. Which, if you can recognize patterns, you should be able to tell what exactly it's going to be. But I think it can come back either day or night, doesn't matter. Like it did with Masu. Alright, up the stairs we go. And this room we go, and hey! I finished your shopping list. Aha. Yeah, if words can't express how happy you would, you'd think she'd give me some praise or something. But whatever. But yeah, she gives us some gold dust, and I realize I haven't used the other gold dust yet we got from Masu. So we'll go ahead and use that and use it on our Thunder Edge, and just for good measure, we'll power up our best rosary too. So all right. We got three powered up items, and, well, gonna go get one more wanted quest, wanted list, wanted monster list, dead monster wanted list, taken care of. And to do so, we're gonna head to Kamui. The best place to figure out where this wanted quest is, wanted list is, I can never say that right, is to look right by the Mermaid Spring. There's a house right by it that has some sheep. Sheep I don't think we've fed yet, actually. So let's go ahead and feed these sheep that we haven't fed yet, with the herbs that we haven't fed it yet that we just now have. And that lands us 12 praise. Another, just a small spoonful in a gigantic bucket, but it still helps. So, this guy over here, Wally, is the guy that we need to talk to. He also, too, for, additionally, has a problem. Turns out this guy has had nothing but misery and misfortune happen for like the past 5 months. He talks about the old legend that has Asuna's grandfather in Shiranui, if you haven't put that together yet. I don't know why Yasun's calling him young man. I mean, he looks like at least 32. Is he a youngster? Maybe he should be a little bit shorter if he's a youngster. But whatever. Oh, sorry. It wasn't 5 months. It was a year ago. He's up in the village where the sword is. But he touches it. And then, well, I'll let him explain it. I feel like this is what Hideki Kamiya wants to happen to all the insects who bug him about Star Fox Zero and Bayonetta 3 and all that shit. Then they're always being... he's always being watched by him? So alright, we've got igloo turtles to deal with. 5 of them! definitely the hardest wanted list we're gonna have to deal with. But again, we're so powerful at this point, it doesn't really matter. It's not gonna be too much of a problem for us. So let's get to it. Alright, I think our first guy is right outside, actually. So we'll go ahead and turn it night. And wait for the transition, and there he is! Where did you pop up out of nowhere? So come on over here. Cold Remorse! He didn't even wait at all. He was waiting for me. Yes, Isun, I understand that this is one of the one of this. That's what we're doing this whole... I get it, it's okay. So alright, I think the best course of action would be to get rid of the weaker enemies before going for the Igloo Turtle so you can dedicate all your time on that. And Veil of Mist only really works when it's vulnerable, because if you remember, or if you haven't remembered, you gotta weaken it, and then you gotta set it on fire so it exposes weak points, and then you gotta attack it from there. And that's when Veil of Mist comes in handy, so you can attack it at maximum damage without giving it enough time to regenerate and respawn and have to go through another whole damn cycle. That's Cold Remorse in the bag! Kiss on you for an extra deep effect. Alright. Kamui is the best place to farm for enemies and money because they give you thousands of yen compared to just a few hundred. Alright. Cold Remorse. Now, how did that register? Answer me that. Alright. Next spot, let's head north a little bit. Up towards the frozen waterfall where Whephear is. Because waiting right by the path is this guy. Again, waiting for innocent villagers and travelers and merchants to steal their money and take their souls and all that shit. Or maybe just freeze them to death and creep them out with the weird straw doll that he has in there. I don't know. I'm not even going to try to begin to understand yokai. That is not a world for me. Alright, so the Igloo Turtle is now vulnerable. Let's do what we normally do. Good thing we have the reflector on us, so we can use that as a fire pool if we can't reach his lantern tail back there. But with our powered up weapons, it doesn't take long at all. Nicely done. Yeah, that was a nice hunk of change right there. So alright, that is yet another enemy in the bag. I forgot which one it was. Was it Snowy Stigma? Yeah, okay, it was Snowy Stigma. I wasn't even really paying attention to what it was. Alright, next one is just straight ahead, really. Right toward the entrance to Yoshpet. There's no way that the devil's getting through the sacred gate of Yoshpet. Even though it's kind of already cursed, so maybe he can, or maybe he came from the cursed parts of Yoshpet. Frozen Penitence! I had to say his name so I remembered. I wouldn't forget when the battle was over. I'm thinking maybe I can use his fire to automatically... No, I have to get him vulnerable first. That kind of stinks. But hey, it's good to experiment this kind of thing, I suppose. I thought I hit him already. What the... Okay, I'm locked onto that enemy, and the camera won't cooperate. I can't. Come on. No. So, come on. Okay, I got the demon thing at least, so if I have to two-cycle this, it won't be too bad. Come on. No. Oh, shit. Well, I don't think I'm gonna get my cherry tree when it comes to time. But I think we'll be alright. Oh, hey. Okay, set him on fire, and then attack him. There we go. Alright. That's Frozen Penitence in the bag. Sheesh. I'm putting all this into one episode so that way we don't have to spend a whole lot of time on this. We're wrapping up, so we might as well get what we can done out of the way as soon as we can. So, alright, Frozen Penitence. Perfect! Alright, next place is further down south towards the Frozen Lake. I think he's kind of hanging by the merchant, maybe? Well, it's one of these two guys. This guy? It was! Stalking Blizzard! I knew he was following me! How appropriate! And oh wow, there's two Igloo Turtles. Alright, so can you remember which one was the actual, stalking Blizzard? Because if you defeat one, well then. The other one's defeated too. So let's see if this is the right one, but I'm gonna see if I can set them both on fire. So have him, be unconscious and out of the way. Keep doing Veil of Mist. I think that was it.
I think I just got lucky, but you know what?
So, okay. Wow, that's almost 10,000 yen. We didn't start with a whole lot of yen. We had like, what, 27,000 or something? Now we got like almost 100,000. So that's doing good. And hey, look at that! There's only one guy left! One Fate Demon Scroll guy. I can't get enthusiastic because this has been a really grueling endurance test. I'm sorry. But I think he's right by the grotto over here. Yeah, there he is. Creeping Igloo. He's creeping around by the dirty hole out. God, cut that. Alright. So, last fight. It's just, he's got smaller enemies to try and distract me from taking him out. I don't know if they keep respawning or not. I don't think they do. Alright, looks like my, shit bomb worked, and oh shit, I gotta go get the other two. Shit, no! Oh, man. I forgot that demon things can go away. I should have got them when I had the chance, but I got distracted. I got to throw it away, damn it. And I don't think that, I can get those back. I think once they're gone, they're gone. Yeah, I figured as much. I can't hit all that fire for some reason. Oh well. Again, there are other opportunities to farm for Demon Fangs. There is never a time where you cannot get Demon Fangs, after all. Especially now when we have most of the moves. Alright, that's the last one in the bag! That was... Oh god, that was like 18 monsters we had to defeat. And we broke 100,000 yen, too. I'm so excited. So, alright. Cross out the last one on our list here. Creeping Igloo. And the last one was a perfect stroke. Sniff him out is the new trophy that we get now. And oh my god, I'm so happy. We got a new trophy. That means we're that much closer to getting the platinum. We can't close things out yet though. I know it's going on a bit long, but we just can't quite close it out yet. So I've got a couple things we need to do first. First thing we need to do is we gotta turn in our list. I mean, yeah, we got the trophy, but we still gotta get our, our gold dust for doing it. You never know, we might wanna use that extra gold dust for something else. Might even sell it if we want to, who knows? So, he doesn't have anything to give us except, again, just some gold dust. Why does everybody who has a grudge against monsters have gold dust? Maybe it's not the monsters that are the problem, but it's the gold dust that's the problem. Maybe the monsters are attracted to the gold dust, and I don't know. But alright, let's see, what can we do now? Let's see. Oh yeah, there's a merchant over here. Let's see if we can't get our money up, because, to do the next thing on our list, we gotta get our money way, way up. We have 100,000 gold right now. We need to get, we need to quadruple that. So let's sell what we have right now. See, treasures, yeah, we got some treasures that we can sell. That silver pocket watch is gonna be a pretty penny, and, well, we've almost made it to almost 200,000 now. So we'll see, and let's sell everything else we don't need, because combat at this point is pretty much done and over with. All the difficult combat stuff isn't gonna be until the end of the game, and even then, we're so overpowered that that's not even gonna be much of a challenge at all. So, yeah, let's sell these Steel Soul Sakes, too. That'll give us 5,000 yen. So we got 218,710 yen, but again, we're gonna need to get it to, about 400,000 yen before we can get to what we need to do. So, last thing we'll do is we'll go ahead and alleviate our praise, because we have almost 700 praise. I'll go ahead and increase the Astral Pouch, and then we'll go ahead and increase the Astral Pouch again, and then, I need to get more praise, but there isn't a whole lot of praise left in the... Okay, we're in trouble. We'll see you next time on Let's Play Okami HD. Oh man, gotta get praise.